Let's remind ourselves of some of the action that we crammed into the last 20 minutes. Freddie Slater started on pole, remember that? Alicia Palmowski got alongside him into Redgate Corner, but ultimately the inside line would prevail for the R Racing driver, and the championship leader would lead them through the first right-hander. Palmowski then, by trying to contest that on the outside, did lose second place to Finn Harrison on the run down through the Crater Curves, as they all got cleanly through the first corner. Harrison then started to attack Freddie Slater for the race lead, as they really didn't work together terribly well. Palmowski able to go with them. So too was the number 19 machine of Mikey Porter and the number 48 of Hopkinson. A five-car battle then ensuing at the front of the pack, with Freddie Slater, the points leader, trying his best to stay at the front of that group. He wasn't quite able to do it though, because Alicia Palmowski, with some brilliant overtaking, was able to get up the inside and briefly take sole ownership of the race lead. But Slater did not want to give up, got right back alongside coming out of Goddard's, and despite being on the outside down into Redgate, would run side by side through the first couple of corners. Then big contact down through the Crater Curves, and that took Porter and Hopkinson off into the gravel trap. Yellow flags were therefore out at the old hairpin for a little while, which took away a possible overtaking opportunity. That still left plenty more though, and Freddie Slater bounced back nicely, having briefly been off the podium, to get the lead back away from Alicia Palmowski with a late lunge into Redgate Corner. Finn Harrison, I reckon, just got the move into second made before the yellow flags, but he would later pick up a penalty for exceeding track limits. He was not the only one. Then Alicia Palmowski tapped into a spin by the aforementioned Harrison. Charlie Hart ran into the back of him, and that dislodged the front bodywork on the number 50 car, which, amongst other things, including a track limits penalty, saw him drop down the order. It was Hugo Schwarzer, though, who claimed the race victory after even Freddie Slater received a five-second penalty. The number 7 car led across the line, but it was Hugo Schwarzer who claimed his first race victory of the season in dramatic fashion here at Donington Park.